so yeah, everybody's all grumbly. I'm grumbly today. I don't know. Some person was like, no, actually, that was not what I was here for. I was here to say I took a shower today, and it's amazing. My hair got all fluffy. It's like my weekly deal. Take the shower. It's kind of fun. It's a fun thing to do, isn't it, to take showers? And I don't know. It's better because then you don't use so much soap all the time. You know what I'm saying? Soap, like the shampoo. And so you're not like constantly needing to buy a bottle of those. You know? It's kind of nice. Anyway, so I'm really switching off. I'm already like tired. I'm not tired. Actually, I'm really full of energy. I'm the opposite. I'm just switching my diet again because I failed at what I was doing. It was too like drastic. So I went back to eating again, but then it was too much eating, vegan eating. And so then now I'm switching back to more fruitarian style, but more mono-fruitarian style. Well, not only fruit, but yeah, more mono. So it means just having like one meal of one style of fruit. So, and then another meal of another style of fruit. It's tough to limit and say one fruit. It's tough to say it's only going to be bananas or it's only going to be mangoes. It's very tough. Because then there's berries and then there's nectarines and you kind of want to have more of a buffet. But the whole point of it is for the digestion to go as little work as possible. So you're not supposed to force your body to go to work. To digest, it's just going to be like, you know, banana meal, and then the next one is more like the mangoes. So it's kind of fun. It's a fun diet, but but then in the evenings, I think, I don't know, I am gonna try to stick a little more with, what would the evenings be? I don't know, something else. Like, I think in the evenings you're supposed to add, like they say, like a sweet potato is good, cooked or not. But yeah, so yeah, mono mealing. And I guess it's the whole point of it is your body is not trying to mix in all of these things at once, and so for sure you're getting the nutrition out of that one type of food. It's almost similar to the Atkins guy, remember him? He was the Atkins, Charles Atkins, I think it was the Atkins diet. We were all supposed to eat like your blood type. Yeah, well that works for some people, it didn't work for me. Anyway, so I'm using this floor wax. If this floor wax is a, I just got it at like the Superstore Home Depot style. I think it's like a floor shine or something like that. So you put it in there, you swish it around, and then you cook it. And then off you go. You point your feet. Let me see. Are they pointing? Yeah, they're pointing. So my feet still point. That's good. And my hair still curls. And I'm gonna go back to try to get in the shape. Oh, you know what? I saw this woman and she did 96 fouettés and it was ridiculous. She went into the circle around, you know? She did the circle one around where you do the quarters and it was really thrilling. So now she got me going. So anyway, I'm gonna get up and work a little bit. Oh, ballet. I went off Bournonville, but it's very good for you, what can I say? Just has a lot of arounds in here, you know, a lot of time. And that can be so arduous. I don't know, sometimes I'm just spazzing out. Wait, you know what? I also fixed the toilets. These are all things that I did under the guise and ownership of eating bananas. I had so much energy. I planted 3 plants. And they're plants, they're just plants. I fixed the toilet. I made like the new, what do you call that thing? Like the seal at the bottom where you have to remove the bolts and you take the tank off. I did all of this, you know. I only ate some bananas. That's it. So it's really kind of energetic, very power-making type of food. I don't feel like taking a nap or sleeping, so it's very, very... And now what am I going to do, you know? What am I going to do? You know what I'm saying? It's a type of a hit. So because we are this 95% and 99% ownership of the monkey family, a human being, because we are monkeys, that much shared inside our bodies, you know, everything. That means, oh my gosh, why would we be fighting? Why would we be fighting that 5% or that 1% and saying, I'm human, why, you know, for my diet? Why would we be fighting it? In a way, it's ludicrous. No wonder so many people are sick. Because if that 5%, if that 1%, you know, of human food, have to have human food, you know, and that's ruling the rest of our 95% of what we are genetically made of. If that's robbing us, you know what I'm saying? That's a big rob. It's not like saying, you know, we're human 95% and then maybe 5% monkey. It's the other. It's the other way around. You know, our insides are 95% to 99% monkey. You know, so we are not sharing, we're not sharing their meal time like we should. You know, that one little percent, I mean, what is it? Maybe add a coriander seed, I don't know. But the 1% is minuscule on the scale of human diet. It's just minuscule. And I'm looking at you can look at the banana girl. She's kind of silly. She goes out there naked or whatever and eats her bananas. but then there was a you can look at the diet of the things that you peel, things that you pick, things that you can peel that don't require tools. And well, monkeys use tools a little bit, but no, I don't want to eat ants off a twig. But it's almost like things that you can just select off a tree, like an avocado, like mango, a nectarine, a peach, plum, any of those things. You know, I can select those off a tree. Therefore, my body is just like, hey, this way you go. That's what monkeys eat, what comes off those trees, you know. Anyway, I've got to get back to my work. My work as a poet dancer. I hope I'm not the last.